I'm gonna have to send Callistees over there. Yeah, send him up.
Of course.
I hope we can get this in time. Aretas will stay there. Aretas does not have much intelligence. There's not much left for him to show, except for this. And then, yeah, if he's making a round tour like that, unless he comes back down here, in which case we're going to have trouble pushing this switch, he might come down here. I can't do it yet, damn it. She can make it there next round. She's really close. Where are you running off to? Tiber, talk to the guy. I don't have much time, etc. Okay, so I just try to have her when he's not looking. Let me just check. Yeah, she's her only inability are in these things. Everything else, quick fingers, deception, all that stuff is equal. But how many things can you throw before the guy catches on? We can get 65. Or... let me just see. We can get 100% throw something. Same. He sweeps a proud hand across the width of a wide view screen as if he has personally created the scene below. Many names the world. No one can agree anymore. For me, it is enough that it is still there, and we are still here. Beautiful, yes? Yes. Questions, have you? Why haven't you and your people settled down there? Because the anchorage is our home, he says briskly, until it is not. He points at some of the brown land masses below. Also, the land on that world is dead. He gestures you along, urging you to follow him. We're about up here. Aretas, right? Oh, that's pointing at Tiber. How come you don't know the name of the world anymore? His cheer over the sight fades a fraction. It is simple. The anchorage is breaking. He hesitates, staring at the air, framing his response. Okay, push the button! Push the button, damn you! I increase my chances to 80% by distracting him from whatever the hell it was. The Lascar sighs, rubbing his eyes. In that second, you dart over and press the glowing button. Alright. I'm gonna keep her there in case we need to press more buttons. His gaze sweeps the room, taking in the flickering panels and scuffed floors. When he finally speaks, he does not look at you. I worry. Lights break. Controls break. These can sometimes be fixed, but the Soralia memory holds? These break, or the connections between them and the Cortex break. These we cannot fix. The anchorage is losing its memories. He lets a long breath go, then nods. We must continue our tour now, if you are ready. Uh-oh. I'm not ready. I have more questions. Damn it. Press it.
Fine.
Oh, we can do this now? Command the Cortex to process the data on the helmet. Certainly. Please wait. Dark masses within the giant orb shift, and a pinpoint of light streaks from within, dancing over the helmet in your hands. Processing complete. Report. Geminar Achille was struck and killed at the date of her last record. Her file has been updated to reflect this information. Analysis continues. I'm nervous, guys, that we're not going to have time for this, especially because I took extra time for this. All of the images contained inside the helmet strobe rapidly through your vision. The images of the night sky that was so prevalent in the helm appear now, and the Cortex begins to layer star charts over the top of those pictures. The information about the location of this world has now been added to my memory. Ask if the images in the broken helmet match any in the Cortex's records.
I'll remember that.
Based on time regression analysis of star field and relative planetary position, only one possible world matches. Ishtrinu, the world the Lascar people call home. Well, that makes sense that her memories are from there.
Yes.
Continue the Cortex removal process. I don't think we can. The Cortex removal procedure has been completed. The Cortex can now be removed from its framing mechanism. Alternately, the information on the broken helmet you found can now be analyzed. Can't do it yet. Next round. Keep her there. Where's he going? Down here? Good, we don't have to pull any more quick finger stuff. I was hoping he'd go down here instead of back over there. Don't have much time, etc. Remove the Cortex before Genji returns to his post. Sounds like a good idea. Got it. The vast glowing sphere dims and stills as a smaller orb drips out of it, arcing lazily toward you like a tiny planet. You raise your hand and snatch it out of the air. The Cortex is yours. You retrieve this tiny metal incense sphere from inside a larger device. It is the navigational Cortex of the Lascar's anchorage, containing records of innumerable worlds and maps of the travel routes between them. You can see infinitesimally small patterns traced along its surface, with minuscule lights racing along and through those patterns.
Ready.
With the Cortex removed, the console is dark and silent. Imagine putting it back. Now we're getting the hell out of here. As far as I can go, which is sadly only this far.
Go.
Sir, I have questions. Okay, please stop here and tell us about this thing. Thank you. See the pit. Here we control the parts of the anchorage we understand. The parts we do not understand, we do not touch. This has gotta be the end of the tour. Cannot tell you much of the pit. Apologies. Some secrets here, and not for the hearing of outworlders. Ha ha ha. Option one's funny. Why do you call it a pit? Is the wrong word? He frowns to himself, murmuring in his own language a moment. No. Lower space in comparison to higher space is pit. Maybe is not beautiful word, but is correct one. He gestures you along, urging you to follow him. No, you can't. It's time for more questions. Can't you tell me anything about this you wouldn't normally tell outworlders? He ponders your question. No. He gestures you along, urging you to follow him, etc. Okay, I have to get the hell out of here. Escape the anchorage with the Cortex. Unfortunately, I travel very slowly. Can I switch a cipher? Wait. I can't, because I have to give it to somebody else. Can I switch an ornament? Hastened if I change this. Oh, I can hasten myself. I can't. I can't change it in combat. I'm moving way too slowly. Hopefully we won't take offense at this. Interesting. You don't use much of this place, but you keep it clean, even the parts that are failing. He ponders your words for a long, silent moment, translating perhaps. At last he grins. Yes, this is what the anchorage means to us. He chews his lips, thinking of how to respond to your observation. But he's thinking, right? Instead of moving, he's taking an action now, I think. Still looking at the pit, Genji's nods once and continues his thought. The anchorage is our home, but it is not ours. It belongs to our people. To our world. We are residents. Caretakers. We protect the anchorage so the ship will find it. So they know we have cared for it. He nods again, satisfied with the response, and waves you along. One more stop on the tour. My favorite. Are you going to the Cortex? You can't show us that, right? You're not going there? Where else? Where the hell else would you go? Did he show us? He showed us this thing, right? Yeah, he went around, all the way around. Who's currently selected? Tiber? We should get him ready to go as well.
All right.
Since he won't answer any more questions now. We kind of all have to escape here, don't we? Here comes the Boredom Slayer. He agrees. Alright, as far as we can go, just... God, hardly any.
Yes, now.
She can go far. Wow. Wish I could travel like she does. Where are we going to? I'm curious, but we have to leave now.
On my way.
If you want a job done right,
then you run this way. Go all the way up here.
On it.
She might be able to get through the next turn. That'd be awesome.
In this world, then.
She's gonna go through. Party scattered. Are you still interested in the tour? If no, I must return to my work. And me,
All right.
We did it. I feel bad though. These guys are like doomed. Hopefully they can find their way without it. What's the magmatic annulet? Oh my god, really? The Cortex revealed Achilles' discovery. The Ninth World is actually the Lascar's home. I should report this to Captain Janner right away. That's what it showed us with the skies. If I go through, though, they're all going to attack. Saving. We'll see if this is still possible. And I can't... Yeah, I can't even split up the party. I'm saving. If they take it from me or I get in this huge battle, I'm just going to restore. I'm not in the mood for that. I'm not going to kill all these guys.
On it.
I just want to tell her that. If I can. I didn't even realize that. Probably would have had an option to tell her. It seems unlikely. He hasn't returned yet.
I'll remember that.
Quest failed. A metallic voice echoes from near the door's panel, though you can see no speaker or vent. Apologies. Sensitivities within anchorage. No visitors allowed. Return later. But I must tell you... Damn it. Can I slip a piece of paper through or something?
Yes, now.
Yeah. Through an airlock. Oh well. Quest failed. I'm not doing that all over again. Would have been neat, but I didn't realize that was what that was. Alright, yeah, quest failed. Okay, does he want the Cortex? Because... If so, he can have it in return for something. And we need to sleep soon. Luckily, what's-her-name is nearby. I'd just sleep before I talk to him. We might need some, what do you call it? persuasion, points, stuff like that.
Happy to help.
Kian will be happy to help us as well. Oh yeah, so what if I try to use this thing? Let's rest first and then just
do stuff.
Because you never know, that might be like a mirrorcaster or something. We might have a story to play through, so let's get all our points back. Because one of us is especially drained.
Let's go.
Where is she? I love these free rests. I can't believe I didn't ask her that question yet. Shh. Okay,
never
let's
felt better than I do right now.
Game saved. Can I use this thing and then give it to him? You pull the cortex out and hold it, and as you focus on it, a pale blue symbol discreetly appears in your vision, overlaying reality. It's a small encircled plus sign, and somehow, instinctively, you know that it's a location finder. It blinks quietly, but insistently, waiting for you to acknowledge it. Where am I now? A broad spinning disc with arms that spiral around a bright center appears in your vision, lingering long enough for you to realize that this is an image of stars. And then the view changes as the cortex's picture rushes toward a small point in one of the spiraling arms. It resolves into a reddish-yellow star with seven dots circling it in roughly elliptical orbits. Three of these appear to be rocks, while others are gassy giants. The cortex pauses here for a moment and then focuses on the second rock. It is primarily blue, with a single dominant continent and scattered island chains. The view rushes toward an inland sea in the southeast of this four-pointed landmass. Cool. So this is where we are now. This is what the Earth looks like now, guys. A broad spinning disk with arms that spiral around a bright center. The Milky Way. Stars. Millions of stars! Billions and billions! And then the view changes. A small point. It resolves into a reddish-yellow star, or sun, with seven dots circling it. Seven planets. Okay. I know that Pluto's not considered the ninth planet anymore. What other planet is missing? Because we've only got seven here. Three of them are rocks, others are gassy giants. Okay. Mercury. Earth. Venus, I suppose. Of course, the gassy giants would be Saturn and Jupiter. Not sure about Neptune. Neptune is gassy, I believe, but not a giant. There's a planet or two missing. The second rock. The second rock. We're missing Mercury or Venus. One of those is gone. Because we're now, Earth is now the second planet from the sun. So we've got one single dominant continent with scattered island chains. We are in the southeast of this four-pointed landmass. So, if you're thinking something like, obviously, it's not North America, but basically we're in the equivalent of Florida. Because I don't know where, you know, in southeast this is. It's obviously, the continent is probably bigger than North and South America. Local denizens refer to this planet as the ninth world. It has also been called Dirt, or Earth. I thought that was Drit. Script flows across the bottom of your vision, presumably matching the voice's words. It's going to say the same thing, right? Oh, yeah. That's cool. Alright, dude. You want this thing? Because there's nothing else I can do with it. It's pretty cool, but... Alas, you do not. He doesn't want this now? Or he wants the other thing first? Sheesh. Dracogen professed interest in the Cortex, but he refused to speak further about it until I bring him the magmatic amulet. Alright. Next episode, guys. Going through the Maw to the trade post, which is in the Chirurgeon slump. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next episode, guys, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.